Hello dear learners, welcome to Engineering Chemistry lecture. Unit number 2, Fuels and Combustion. I am Professor Makarand Kulkarni from Sanjeevani College of Engineering, Kobargaon. Let us start the lecture number 1. What you are going to learn in today's lecture? First, introduction, classification of fuels, then calorific value, GCV, NCV, and lastly the units of calorific value. Let us start with the introduction. What is my fuel? A fuel is the substance which on combustion produces a large amount of heat. Let us check the reaction. Fuel in presence of oxygen, when we heat at high temperature, it is a formation of a combustion product plus heat. So the substance which on combustion releases the large amount of heat known as a fuel. Classification of fuels. First, primary fuels which occur in nature. Example is coal, petroleum and natural gas. Secondary fuels which are derived from the primary fuels. Example coke, gasoline, coal gas, etc. So these are the two fuels, primary and secondary. Calorific value. What is my calorific value? Calorific value of a fuel is nothing but the total quantity of heat liberated when a unit mass or volume of the fuel is burned completely. Calorific value is of two types. First, that is higher or gross calorific value, also called as GCV. It is nothing but the total amount of heat produced when unit mass or volume of the fuel has been burned completely and the products of the combustion have been cooled to room temperature or not to allow to escape. So whatever the amount of heat generated after combustion of fuel, we called as a calorific value. And if that heat is cooled at room temperature or not allowed to escape, and then the calorific value is calculated, is known as higher or gross calorific value. How to determine the gross calorific value? Look at here. GCV is equal to NCV, that is net calorific value, plus 9 into H into latent heat of water upon 100. What is by H? It is the percentage of hydrogen required for the combustion of the fuel. Second is lower or net calorific value, also known as a NCV. It is the net heat produced when the unit mass or volume of the fuel is burnt completely and the products of the combustion allowed to escape. Now again, whatever the heat produced by the complete combustion of the fuel, the product whatever form are allowed to escape or it is not to cool. And then the calorific value is calculated in terms of calculated is known as NCV. What is by NCV? NCV is equal to GCV minus 9 into H into latent heat of steam. Again, H is nothing but the percentage of the hydrogen. So NCV is equal to GCV minus 0.09 H into latent heat of steam. So lastly, NCV is equal to GCV minus 0.09 into H into 587 calorie per gram or kilocalorie per gram. What is the 587? It is the latent heat of the steam. So by using this formula, when you know the GCV, we can easily calculate the NCV of that particular fuel. What are the units of calorific value? Calorific value is determined in the system like CGS, MKS or SI. So look at here, CGS unit for solid and liquid it is calorie per gram, and for gaseous fuel it is calorie per liter. MKS it is kilocalorie per kilogram, and for gaseous it is kilocalorie per meter cube. SI unit for solid and liquid is joules per kilogram, and for gaseous fuel it is joules per meter cube. And here it is the relation, that is 1 calorie per gram is equal to 1 kilocalorie per kilogram, which is equal to 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram. What you all learned from today's lecture? First, introduction to the fuel. Second, classification of the fuel. Third is calorific value, which having a two type, that is gross calorific value and net calorific value. And lastly, units of the calorific value. Thank you.